We lift to you our nation,
yes,
the United States of America.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord. Lord, you love this nation.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
Lord, this nation was founded, yes, according to your word,
yes,
according to your purpose. Yes.
Thank you,
Lord. Lord, to bless the nations,
yes, bless the nation,
and to exalt you, O God.
Yes.
Lord, they call this the border, yes, Israel.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we just pray that your purpose be accomplished.
Yes.
Along the way, Lord, we have failed thee, Lord, as a nation. Lord, forgive us. Forgive our iniquities.
Yes, Lord.
Forgive the arrogance, Lord. Forgive the pride, Lord. Forgive,
yes,
Lord, our idolatrous practices, Lord.
Yes,
forgive,
Lord,
our selfishness as a nation.
Yes, Lord.
Forgive our, Lord, love for pleasure more than lovers of God.
Yes, Lord.
Forgive, Lord, our God, our immorality, Lord, the,
yes,
divorce, Lord, the gay movement, Lord, the political, yes, upheavals, Lord, the terrorism, oh God, Lord, forgive us, Lord, we come to you in the name of Jesus,
yes,
and Lord, we pray, Father, that as you raise America again, Lord, as you raise us up,
yes,
as you raise this,
yes,
nation, Lord, to exalt your glory, oh God, to exalt and spread your word among all nations,
yes,
oh God.
Lord. Yes.
Lord, we pray, Father God, that your purpose for this nation will be accomplished in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We come against all the works of the enemy in the name,
right,
of Jesus.
Name of
all
Jesus.
Terrorism, all attacks by the enemy,
yes,
Jesus'
name,
all immorality, all worldliness and carnality, we come against those in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Lord, and as we face a crucial stage in our history, Lord, in the national election in 2016,
yes,
Lord, we pray, O God, that you will move in the heart of every Christian, Lord, every American, O God. Lord, to be sensitive, Lord, to your voice, Lord, to vote, O God, and Lord, to know what to do, Lord, and who to vote for, O God. For you said, Lord, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding, on your ways. Acknowledge him and he will direct your paths, oh God. Lord, that you will, Lord, raise up, Lord, a godly leader, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
A leader that you have chosen, oh God, at such a time like this.
Yes,
we thank you, Lord, for the recovery of this nation. Lord, this nation, oh God, Lord, will declare once more your glory, oh God,
yes,
for all nations of this
world.
In Jesus' mighty name.
God is a great God. We just keep on asking the Lord to raise us up, all of us, to be a missionary wherever God wants us to be. God says in His Word, in His Word, pray of the Lord of the harvest that they would send laborers. I know that the vineyard is already ripe for harvest. But we need people to harvest the soul.
Hallelujah.
We will keep on praying for,
yes, Lord,
for God to send missionaries not only in the States but abroad. Later, I'd like to ask Pastor Francis, our very own missionary. Do you know that even like 2 years ago, every year we collect them offering and we send them to mission. Send to mission, and Pastor Francis is just came back recently from mission trip to Mindanao, basically, and teaching us a non-Christian. I'd like to ask him to pray, because he's the one, firsthand, he saw the need. And then, you know what, after this event, I'd like to ask you to pray. We will collect offering for mission. This is what it's all about. Perhaps you don't have the time, amen? We don't have an opportunity to go like him, but we can be part of that by simply,
amen,
giving gifts.
Amen.
And whatever we will be collecting, we always support. You know, don't have a lot of money, but we give easily. Second gifts. So I'd like to ask Pastor Francis, we pray for missions.
Thanks, Praise God.
Father, we humbly bow before you, O God. We thank you that you are here in our midst, O God. We thank you that you are concerned for those who are unsaved and those who are backslidden, O God. And we just ask, this, dear God, that you are the Lord of the harvest, that, Lord, touch every heart, even tonight, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
That we, all of us, will become a missionary, Lord God.
Yes.
And you know everything what is happening surrounding the whole world, oh God. You are concerned for the lost, oh God. That's why calamities come. That's why tragedies come, to remind us that there is God who is longing for the salvation of people. God, we ask that even us, oh God, who are here in your presence, Lord, touch our hearts, oh God. That we may become a missionary as well, to be a testimony of God to every person, O Lord God. For the soul is very important for you, Lord. The human being is important to you, Lord God. And we just ask, God, that as you have called Isaiah, Elijah, Jeremiah, Paul, Silas, and everybody in the Bible, Lord God, Lord, we are here. Call us, Lord. Touch us, Lord. Use us for the glory of your name. Make us a missionary, Lord God. Make us like a postman, Lord God, bringing the good news of salvation.
Yes.
And we ask your divine goodness, your presence, Lord, the most important, Lord, that we be able to be used as a tool for the harvest in our times, Lord. We know that this is the last harvest, Lord. This is the last outpouring of your presence, Lord.
Hallelujah.
We ask your sweet, mighty anointing upon us and upon all the places that we go, Lord. We ask the fire of your anointing, Lord, to blow, that people will be saved, Lord God, as they hear the word of God. Lord, we ask your provision for everyone, especially those who are in the midst of the mission, Lord God. Even right now, oh Lord, we ask your divine provision upon them. Give them parsonage, to a place to live with, Lord God, while they were doing the mission, Lord God. We ask your anointing to flow for the healing. Lord, we ask your divine presence always with the missionaries, Lord God, that they may be able to do it accordingly as you have planned for them, to bring the good news of salvation. Lord, we cannot do anything without you, Lord God. It is not the money, it is the persons of God that we have called. This is the last calling, O Lord God. We ask, Lord, that those who are not even a missionary that you are using as a tool, Lord God, Lord, empower them, anoint them, pour out your presence upon them, Lord, and just bring the people unto the harvest, O God. We just ask even, Lord, that, Lord, we don't really need the intelligence. We just need your presence. As you have said to Jeremiah, I have put the words into your mouth. Go! God, this is the time, just like in the time of Jeremiah. Lord, we just ask your presence be with us, Lord God, that we may be able to do everything that you want us to do, that your name will be honored and be exalted in every place, of God. Lord, we thank you for tonight. We thank you, Lord, that you are here and reminding us that the time is very short, Lord God. We just ask that you would touch every heart in this building right now. And Lord, I pray even the signs and wonders will be experienced in our midst, oh God. Lord, this is no coincidence, oh God. For tonight you are reminding us that the time is indeed very short. I just pray, dear God, that we will be sensitive to your calling. And Lord, we just ask, Lord, we will say yes to you, O God.
Yes.
Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory and praises and honor to you, for you are the harvester. I just pray that you would bring the harvest in our churches, Lord God. You will be exalted and be given the praises and the glory and the honor. Thank you, Father God, in Jesus' name. Everybody say,
Amen.
We'll just give our hands to prayer. This time I'd like to ask, you know, you can see, we would like to pray, especially in having the election. It's very crucial. You know, the church needs to vote, regardless of who do you prepare. We're not endorsing any candidate, but at least use your right, the right to vote, and the right to say. So, this time we will be praying that God will give us wisdom. Of course, kids, we only have two choices. To choose. But whoever it is, the Lord will raise up what God wants to be the leader of this nation. So can you imagine if we don't vote, see what happened in the past 8 years? Everything, gay marriage become legal and so on. Because we don't probably use our right to vote. We don't care. But you know, God has bringing us here in America. It's a privilege for us to use it. Whether the person we vote in that way or whatever it is, at least we can exercise that right. So we as Christians should not forfeit that privilege that God has given us. Amen. So I'd like to ask Pastor Melvin to pray for this coming election.
Amen. Father, we thank you so much, Lord, for this wonderful event.
Yes.
You made possible for your people, Lord. And we humble ourselves.
Yes.
And ask you, Lord God, to continue to come to the midst of us and minister to each and everyone.
Yes.
Lord, we just want to thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity.
Yes.
And Lord, tonight, Lord, we ask for your guidance.
Yeah.
Lord, that even the wisdom that comes from you, Lord, is what we need in this coming election, Lord. Lord, we need a leader, a godly leader that has fear unto you, yeah, Lord God. So, Lord, we cry out unto you, Lord. And we ask, Lord, that you just give us the wisdom,
yes,
each and everyone, especially your people, Lord God. And we pray, Lord God, that you choose that people, that you choose that person, Lord,
yes, Lord,
to lead this beautiful country,
yes,
that is founded by your word.
Yes.
And Lord God, tonight, we just acknowledge you as the God who gave that wisdom,
yes,
that you even gave to Solomon, Lord God. And if that's,
yes,
what,
Lord,
we need, Lord, we ask that wisdom, Lord. And we pray, Lord God, that we as your people,
hallelujah,
will come together, Lord God, not because of feeling, but because, Lord, of what you said.
Yes.
And you choose that person, Lord, that is for you, that America is for Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Lord God, so tonight, Lord God, I declare, Lord God, that it's done.
Yes.
Lord, that you choose that person already,
yes,
for us.
Yes.
And tonight, Lord, we are rejoicing with your people, Lord God, tonight. And we declare, Lord God,
yes,
victory in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
America is for Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And we thank you, Lord God,
yes,
for the wisdom that you gave unto us.
Yes.
We claim victory,
yes,
now and forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name,
Jesus.
Amen. Amen.